Good afternoon, my name is Craig Erlam, Market Analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to today's daily update on the markets. Today we're going to look at the major stories moving the financial markets today, starting as always with the key economic data. So far this morning there's been very little data out. We've seen the UK retail sales show an increase last month of 0.1%. This is still a positive figure, but it is much smaller than the 0.6% we saw the month before. But given the unusually poor weather we have seen in the UK over the last couple of months, it actually isn't that much of a surprise. And we do expect the figure to pick up drastically over the next couple of months with having the Olympics. This afternoon we do have the US jobless figures, which are expected to come in at around 367,000. This is a much higher figure than we did see last week, which where we saw a figure of 350,000, but it is also much more in line with the figures we have been seeing over the last couple of months, which have been between 370,000-380,000 range. So like I say, we are expecting still some positive data about the US this afternoon. We're also expecting the Philly Fed Manufacturing Index to show a figure of -7.9. While this is still a negative figure, which does still show that we are expecting business conditions to continue to deteriorate in the near term, it is a much better figure than we saw the month before, so there is positivity in that. However, it does, like I say, still show that there is still a lot more upturn required. Other than this, there isn't really much data out, and the biggest story we've also seen this morning has been the fact that it's been agreed that the EFSF will be used to buy primary and secondary bonds for Spain in order to bring down the bond yield, which as of this morning actually jumped above 7% again, to that point where the other countries, Ireland, Portugal and Greece, all required a bailout. So like I say, this is a positive agreement, and we do expect to see these yields come down over the next 24-48 hours, once the Spanish government officially request this aid from the EFSF to bring down these yields as planned. We haven't had many more details out about this agreement, though. We do know that this is only an agreement for the EFSF to buy these Spanish bonds, as opposed to the ESM. We will need another vote in order to before it can be agreed that the ESM will also be able to buy these bonds in the primary and secondary markets. But it is a positive step for now. And like I say, though, we will hear more details over the next 24 hours or so. This has been a major story in the market so far this morning. We've seen the euro trading higher since the announcement. It's been trading at around 123, right near the top of that triangle that's been trading in for the last week or so. We may see it break out above that this afternoon. However, in my opinion, this is pretty unlikely. Usually the more details that we do see that come out surrounding these announcements, the more pessimistic the market becomes. So we may actually see a retracement back from this area over the next couple of hours. In the cable charts, we've seen sterling trading higher, that trading just below 127. We saw it break out a couple of days ago above that triangle which it had been trading in. Yesterday it stayed above that triangle, which acted as confirmation. So we may see a sustained move higher in this chart over the next couple of days. However, for now it has found resistance around that 55-day moving average. Finally, the last thing we'll be looking at today is going to be these US corporate earnings. We've seen a lot of results out so far already this morning, and we do have some more results to come after the US close, including Microsoft and Google, where we are expecting some more positive results as we've seen so far over the last couple of weeks. For now though, my name is Craig Earl, I'm Market Analyst at Alpari UK. Thank you very much for joining us.